Hello guys, good evening, welcome back. Today we will see how to design, analyze and design a multi-story building. Let me start with a new project. I will click on the new project. I will take it as a space frame. I will enter this as a 3D building and I will take the units as meter and kilonewton. Say next. I will go with open structure wizard. Let me take a bay frame so that it will be easier to demonstrate. So I will say finish. Under the structure wizard, I will select frame models. Under this, I will go with bay frame. Let me assume that a 3-bay, 3-story building. So I will take the length of the building to be 8 meter with 4 2 bays and height as 12 meter and height of each story as 4 meter and width as 12 meter with 3 bays. Okay. So number of bays, I will take this as 3. This height I will take this as 9. Okay, just have a look at this. So it will be along length 2 bays, along the height that will be 3 stories, and along the width it will be 3 bays. So let me apply the frame. So the frame is ready. You can see 2 bays over here and 3 bays on this z axis. X axis 2 bays, 2 bays, and on z axis it will be 3 bays. Let me import this. So for the importing, file, merge model with the start and say yes. So you got the start, so you got the model into the start pro. So this is the actual screen where we work. Now let me go with the general. Under the general, I need to define the properties. Let me assume the section. Let me assume the property like this. All the beams are. Let me define that all the rectangular beams are 350 mm deep and width of 300 mm. I will take the depth to be 400 mm and width to be 300 mm. Z is the width, Z is the width, YD is the depth. Depth I have taken it as 0.4 and width I have taken it as 0.3, 300 by 400. I will say add. Now I will take all the columns to be 300 by 300. I will take all the columns to be 300 by 300, add close. Let me apply like this. So I cannot select each and every column in this 3D model. For that I will use the tool called select. Select by beams parallel to Y axis. So all the columns are selected. This is a global reference axis what we go with. So here is the global reference axis what we go with. So for that select, so we'll go with select beams parallel to Y axis. So 300, 300 will be the parallel axis. Assign to the selected beam, assign, yes. Now I will go with the select beams parallel to X and select beams parallel to Z. So all the beams are selected, beams are selected. Now I will assign the 400 and 300 property. Again I will go with select by missing property. Easy, right? So select by missing property. Whichever the property has not been defined, those are selected, assigned to the selected beam. Assign, yes. So property assignment is done. Let me have a 3D view look of it. So here is the ready rendered model. You can have a look at it clearly. So this will show you, even if you want to change the orientation and all, you can use the beta angle method what I have explained you in the last classes, and you can use the change in the orientation. Make sure that the column orientation will be changed with the beta angle if you want to change the orientation of the beam. You can change it by giving the dimensions. Okay, now I will go with the support. I will assume all the supports to be, let me take the front view. I will select this, create a support, assume to be fixed. So add, let me assign it to the selected node. Assign, yes. Let me take it to the isometric view again. Okay, so nodes have been assigned. Now under the loads and definition, very important case, first I need to add the self weight of that structure. Why? Because it is a RCC structure, so self weight will be very high. Then I will go with the live load, add. Then I have I can go with the roof load. So right now I don't want to deal with the roof load, so I will go with the live load and say close. Let me add the dead load, which is the self weight of the structure. Add, close, and this has to be applied to the entire structure. So assign to view, assign, yes. Now I will go with the live load, add the live load. So I will take the live load as the floor load. Why? Because the load from the floor will be transferred onto the beams, and the beams will in turn transfer it to the column. column entrance transfers it to the foundation. So let me add the load as a floor load rather than every time we were adding it as a UDL on the beams. Now let me add it as a floor load, which will be converted as a load onto the beams. Okay. So usually I will take -5 kN/m² as a floor load. There will be dead floor load, there will be live floor load. Live floor load I will take -5 kN. It will be acting in global y direction. Do we have any one-way slab? If we have one-way action, we have to save it as one-way action. Right now we don't have. Let me take the range. So y-axis, it's from not zero. It will start from here till here. So what is that axis range? Let me go check back and come here. So from the foundation, this is at a height of 3 meters. From 3 meters, I have to take the range to be 6 meters. So 3 meters is the each story height. So under the live load, add floor loads -5 kN/m² as the load. Minimum y range is 3 meters and maximum y range is 9 meters, 3 to 9. Then under the x range, do I need to add anything in x or z? Not required. So let me say add close. So you can see the load acting exactly on the structure, right? So perfectly done. Let me turn it to an extent. You can see the different views. Okay. Let me take it to the x direction. So live load added. Under the dead load, I didn't add the dead load of the slab. In fact, I didn't mention that, but still I will add here. So let me add the dead load of the slab. Under the dead load, I will go with the floor load again. So it will be just -1 kN/m² from range 3 to 9 meters. 3 to 9 meters. Okay. Add close. So let me see this. Yeah, this has been applied. Now I just have a small doubt. The floor load may not be same on the terrace. Why? Because the live loads, dead loads, everything what is coming onto the top terrace will be very less. So for that reason, you can add it as twice, one from 3 to 6, another one at 9 meter. Okay, so if you want to add it in different way, you can do it. Okay, now after addition of the loads, now I will go with the load combination. So new, sorry, I will go with the load combination. Under the load case details, I will add load combination. I will just say 1.5 times of dead load plus live load. 1.5 times of dead load plus live load. Okay, so I will add this load combination. That now my work is to analyze. So commands, analyze, perform analysis, say okay, analyze, run analysis and save. So there are no errors and no warnings. There is a note. Let me have a look at the note. About floor, one way load weighs. So there is one way slab. No. Okay. If there is one-way slab, that would have taken it differently, but it doesn't matter now. That's okay. Now I will go with the post-processing mode. I will apply the combination loads. And you can see the deflection diagram, shear force, bending moment, everything in this for the load combinations. I will just pause this video and make it two parts. So this first part will deal only with the analysis, application of the loads. Part two will deal with the same design of this particular structure. So let's come back with next video. Hello guys, welcome back. In the earlier class, I have done with the analysis of the structure. In this class, let us see how to design the structure. Apart from the analysis, we didn't see the results of analysis. So this is the deflection diagram. If you want to reaction, you can just see the reactions of different structures. You can place them differently. You can pull them off. Okay, so displacement, reactions, everything you can see. If you want the beam results, just click on one particular beam, see the deflection, shear, bending, everything you can see. Okay, for a continuous beam, anything like this, which is three span continuous beam, you can take it in a different way. Right click, I will say go to the new view and say okay. Now you can turn it forward. Let me take it in the side view. Now you can see bending moment diagram for that continuous beam which is taken from the structure. Now if I want to see the results, view values, beam results, bending maximum, annotate, close. You can see the maximum bending moment for that particular beam, which is a continuous three-span beam taken from the structure out. Okay. So if I want the deflection for the same thing, you can see the deflection too. So results, view values, beam results. I want the deflection, right? So deflection, maximum results. Annotate, close. Right. Now let's go to the next part. So we have done with modeling, post-processing. Now I need to start with the design. So let me go back to the modeling. Under that, you have, after the analysis, you have something what is called as design. Under that, so this is a concrete structure. Before that, I need to take the entire structure in, display whole structure. You can just have a click over here to display the whole structure. Okay. Now, type of structure what I am designing is concrete. So let me take the concrete. Under that, I need to select the codes which I am supposed to use. So here I am using IS 456-2000. So this is IS 456-2000. Let me select the code. Now, after selection of the code, entire thing works with these three commands. Remember this: first select the parameters, then define what the parameters are, then apply those parameters using the commands, and say and run the design. That's all. So let me select the parameters. So to select the parameters, there are somewhere around 32 parameters available. So basing on our requirement, we will define the parameters. So let me say, for example, I know what is the compressive strength of concrete I am going to use. So let me add that parameter. I know what is the yield strength of the main reinforcement. Let me add that one into there. And I know what is the maximum size of the dam, maximum bar size required. So minimum size required for the main reinforcement, I can add this minimum size of the bar. And I will go with maximum size too. Maximum size of the main reinforcement, I will add this. Maybe these four parameters I will just work out for an example, but you can always add more number of parameters so that you will get the optimum design, perfect design, whatever you want. I will say okay for this. After selecting the parameters, I need to define the parameters. So first one is FC, compressive strength of concrete. Let me assume that it is 30 MPa, that is 30 Newton per mm square, or 30,000 kilonewton per meter square. So 30,000 kilonewton per meter square add. Then I will go with FY. FY, I will assume that it is 415 steel or 500 steel. So I will add 415 into 10 power 3, 1, 2, 3. It's in kilonewton per meter square, remember that. So add, and maximum diameter of the bar, I will keep it to 32 and add, and minimum diameter of the bar, I will keep it to 12 and add, close. Now, whatever we have added can be seen over here. Everything I have to apply to the entire structure. Assign to view, assign. I have to take FC, compressive strength of concrete, to be 30 MPa. So assign to view, assign, yes. Then FY, assign to view, FY, assign to view, assign, yes. Then maximum 32 mm, assign to view, assign, yes. Minimum 12 mm, assign to view, assign, yes. So these things have been assigned. Then after defining parameters, I have last thing, commands. So go to commands. Do I have any beams to be designed? Yes. So add that. Do I have any columns to be designed? Yes, add that. Then slabs, no, take off, add, close. Now come down over here, you can see beam design and column design have been added. So which are the beams that has to be selected, which are the columns has to be selected? Design of beams, I will select like this, select beams parallel to X, select beams parallel to Z. So all the beams are selected, design of beams is selected, assigned to the selected beam, assigned, yes. So that parameter has been assigned to all the beams. Now I will go to the columns, select beams parallel to Y. So all the columns are selected, so this is column cursor, so assigned to selected beam, assigned, yes. So column design and concrete takeoff, end of concrete design, everything has been defined. Now I will go with analyze, run analysis, and save. Done. So my part is done. There is one note which was there in the analysis part also. So that analysis part note is continued. Let us have a look at what it has done after analyzing. So you can see these things, a calculating section forces analysis successfully completed. After that, it is performing concrete design. It has started with the concrete design, then calculating section forces, creating section force file, BMD, SFTs, section displays file, creating design information file, and finally it is done. Now let me have a look at the output file, where you will get the maximum information. So let me go to the results, concrete design. So this is the concrete design, what it has taken. So you have given 415 and FC 300 and maximum diameter 32, minimum diameter 12 mm for all. Design of 1 to 6, 16 to 21, 31 to, these are the beams and this is the design of that beam. Say for example, I will take one particular beam which is 4 meter length, 300 by 400 is the size. By default it has taken 25 mm cover and it requires top reinforcement of 245 mm square and bottom 226 mm square. So it has provided 3 bars of 12 mm in one layer and at the bottom 3 bars of 12 mm in the one another layer. So throughout 3 bars of 12 mm in the top and throughout 3 bars of 12 mm in the bottom has worked out for this particular beam. Now it is also telling that 2-legged 8 mm dia stirrup at 150 mm is used. So it has been used 150 mm throughout. 2-legged 8 mm dia stirrup has been used. So similarly, let me have a look at the column design. So these are all the beams that are available over there. So let me have a look at the column design. You can just have a look at this column design if you for once are used. So it's a short column. What type of a column? Short column. Required steel is 104. Required concrete area is this much. Main reinforcement, they have provided just 4 bars of 12 mm dia, 0.5% reinforcement, equally distributed. Provided 8 mm dia, rectangular ties at 190 mm, center to center. Ties are provided at 190 mm. You can get the complete reinforcement information from this. But this is something like, what I can say, it's like a readable thing. Now we need a drawing to be sent to the site. So for that we will use AutoCAD to complete the drawings and we have the advanced version, what is called as RCDC, Reinforced Concrete Design Detailing version, where you can complete the detailing also. Now if I just want the information of a one particular column which has to be start over here, where I need to send the information immediately, if you double click that particular part, go to the concrete design, you can see. So this is a column, you have 4 bars, 300 by 300 is the column size. FY of bar FC is 94 AST, required percentage AST, bar size 12 mm, bar number 4. So 12 mm bars of 4 numbers of 12 mm bars are used. So if I just say print, this will be printed as usual. Okay, if I just want to see the information about this beam, go to the concrete design, you can see 3 bars of 12 mm at the top and 3 bars of 12 mm at the bottom. You can see that stirrups of 8 mm stirrup, 150 mm center to center provided. How many number of stirrups? There are 30 number of stirrups in this. So this is what the information you will get from the design aspect of this particular stirrup. Okay, so how to see that? We have seen it. Now preparation of the report, everything will remain same as usual what we were doing it. Now going with the modeling back again, I will go with the post-processing mode. You can check with this. Then if you want the information regarding the concrete design, just double click it, you will get the concrete design information at the same time. Okay, so let's stop here.